Okay, so welcome everybody. So my name is Olivier Bertrand. I'm working for Trend Micro. I have pre-sales for Belux. So today I would like to talk about the way to integrate the MIS platform and the Trend Micro product, the Trend Micro technology. So you probably know that Trend Micro is leader on the market on the cybersecurity point of control since more than 30 years. We are at different locations. So, for example, you can support and you can secure the server workload on the on-premise data center. We can also apply some security policy directly from Amazon, from Azure, so from those cloud infrastructure. We can do the same with the network inspection. So we have a lot of possibilities directly on the network with the next generation IPS, as well as mail gateway, web gateway, and so on and so on. And finally, we are also seen by Gartner and other neutral judge of evaluator that the user protection is also part of the ecosystem of Trend Micro. So we have developed amongst the years a very nice security engine with more than 13 technology that can protect also the assets, the endpoint protection. So why we are considered as a leader at Trend Micro? It's because we already develop and we can consolidate a lot of information about honeypot, about threat intelligence. But on top of that, we have also invest massively into the proactive research. So that's why we have acquired a lot of R&D units worldwide. And we have also one of the largest bug bounty program to try to figure out what will be the next vulnerability. And as soon as we have this information that we have validated this information as not a false positive, then we will also publish immediately a new filter for the next generation IPS or for the virtual patching on the server and the endpoint to avoid that your resources will be exploited with the vulnerability. And on top of that, since we are on the market since more than 30 years, it's normal that we have one of the biggest data base in the world regarding the threat. So that's also something that is really important to generate a lot of visibility and to be able to detonate on the technology that you have developed. Because without the global intelligence, it won't be possible to detect all the threat. That's why if we just take a look at the statistic, we have in worldwide more than 500,000 customer worldwide. We block a lot of threats in real time, and we keep on working in this way with a lot of security engine like machine learning and so on and so on. So you have with the Trend Micro ecosystem the global threat intelligence, but you can also generate by yourself the local threat intelligence. So we have also the sandbox, which is called the Deep Discovery Analyzer. We can also make use of the machine learning directly on the endpoint, server, and network inspection to be sure that any event, any object or IP of URL or domain name that will be recognized by the system of Trend Micro will also be analyzed by the machine learning and then classify as a threat or maybe as a false positive. And finally, we also accept human-generated elements, like for example, some IOC that you receive from your organization. We are not yet talking about the circle because the MISP, it will be a bit later. But yeah, imagine that you can receive some feeds from IBM X-Force or from all the any other feeds. You can also import it immediately on the system in the ecosystem of Trend Micro. So we can then leverage, and we will leverage on the technology. So you have the global intelligence, you have the local intelligence. So how can we help you with the detection of new threats? So we have different type of technology available right now, and all those type of technology are used to detect a breach. So it's a breach detection, and we will try to associate any kind of threat with one stage of the attack. So for example, if we see that one object is being used as a point of entry, then we will tag this information for later purposes, for later investigation. If we see that an email is trying to abuse lateral movement exploitation, for example, we will also tag this information with the lateral movement tags to be able to then reuse this information for further analysis. We can then sniff all the network communication. We can also block and analyze all the incoming SMTP traffic. And we can do the same with the integration of the sandbox with all the endpoint, with all the point of controls on the endpoint, on the server, on the mail, and also in the cloud. So what will be the connection to the MISP platform? So imagine that you have collected a lot of information about global intelligence of Trend Micro. You have also generated the local intelligence about what you have seen locally. Then we will make use of the technology of Trend Micro, like the sniffer, to export the IOC of your own organization. So anytime that the Trend Micro network sensor will detect, based on the rules that you have defined, that one IOC is used within your organization, then we will send this IOC to the MISP, to the local MISP platform, to be able to enrich, to correlate this information with external threat intelligence. You can do that with the local organization, but you can also connect from the local MISP to an external MISP, like the one from the Circle, for example. Okay, so it's export of information to the MISP platform. And the result will be an automatic generation of an event, like we see this one. It's an APT, so the SIMBOT, HTTP request. So we will generate a new event with some certain tags on it, with a certain severity. And then we will attach to this event a lot of information regarding what we have seen from our technology point of view. So for example, if we have sandboxed this event, this malware, then we will also generate the sandbox report. If we have seen that this malware inside the sandbox talk to a certain domain, we will also append this domain name to the attribute of this event. So a lot of information given for you to be able to correlate, to enrich your analysis. But okay, we know that we all have to leverage and to act on this information. It's good to have this visibility, but okay, how can you be sure that you can reuse this visibility, this element, to also block, contain, remediate, recover from the threat? That's why with the Trend Micro Deep Discovery Director, it's an ecosystem of the APT of Trend Micro, and the Control Manager, we give you the opportunity to also import this information into the management system of Trend Micro. So once you will automatically import the suspicious object, which will be the IP, the URL, domain name, and object as a hash from the MISP, then you will be able to block it, or at least to reuse it, to investigate, to hunt for the threat inside your organization. But also to be sure that once this threat will again occur somewhere in your infrastructure, even if it is coming from the cloud, from the endpoints, on the email gateway, and so on and so on, we will be able to block it directly from the first layer of security engine, which is the check of reputation. Because this information, it has been collected by the management system of Trend Micro, we'll be able to share this information directly to any point of control of Trend Micro, but also to third party. Because we have some structural interconnection with other parametric security vendor, like a checkpoint and so on, we will also be able to submit this information and to talk to the perimeter defense that you have put in place. And so, yeah, finally, so as I mentioned, since we have collected this information directly from the MISP, that we have exported also this information to the MISP for security analysis reason, then we will have to block it and to make use of this information to block the threat over the wire with the next generation IPS. We can do the same also with a vulnerability scanning product, like for example Rapid7 of any other vulnerability report scanning. We can also consume this information and automatically apply a new filter on the network. We can also use the information of the MISP to do some breach detection, so it won't be intrusive. It will be just a way to detect that something is wrong on the network. And we will apply also the custom sandbox to validate that the event generated from the MISP and imported from the MISP will be the right one and won't be a false positive. So it's also something that you can automate. You can be sure that you can import this information into the sandbox of Trend Micro, validate, and once it has been validated, it will be shared among all the points of control of Trend Micro. We can also use this information to be sure that your endpoint and mobile won't be affected by this new threat. So from there, we will make use of the endpoint protection suite, which combine a lot of perimeter control, like email gateway, web gateway, but also the endpoint protection system. And last but not least, when it goes to the cloud or the server environment, we also are able to make use of the MISP-generated event to also block directly for the server purposes the new threat. So any kind of information that comes from all the technology of Trend Micro can be exported to the MISP regarding the APT detection mostly. And all the events and all the information, or practically every information that makes sense, will be imported into the management system of Trend Micro to share then in a second time to any kind of point of control of Trend Micro. So just, this type of integration is based on the Python script, yes. So Python script will be available to you based on your request. And then what we can do also is to make use of the RESTful API of any product of Trend Micro. So you can also automate a lot of processes to be sure that some information will be shared among the point of control, but also can be reused by a third party. So it's common use to make use of the system of deep discovery, for example, Trend Micro, to communicate this information to an external party. So thank you very much for your attention. If you have some question. So we are, indeed. So currently it's not yet publicly closed, but disclosed, but it will be the future, yeah. And I think that better idea is maybe to make use of the MISP platform, but the MISP website, maybe to share this information with among users. Yeah. Any other question? No? Thank you.